There have been 862 episodes of Doctor Who broadcast to date. My mission? For every single one, say something nice. Hello everyone, and welcome back to Say Something Nice. Today we're catapulting forward again to 1987 for Paradise Towers Part 3. Am I a Blue Kang? Am I a Red Kang? I'll never tell, but what I will tell you is that in Paradise Towers Part 3, the moment I've chosen is Pex saving Mel. Now, Paradise Towers is another 80s story that's undergone a bit of a reappraisal in the past few years, and people kind of get the satire of it a bit more now. And the production values may not quite live up to that, but that's okay. The reason I've chosen this moment is that we've already established in the story that Pex tries to act really tough, but deep down, he's really not. And by him bursting in, not even really thinking there'll be trouble, but just trying to look big, he distracts the Rezzies who are trying to eat Mel, and they end up going down the waste disposal unit. So Pex doesn't even sort of set to them or anything or use weapons, and when they try to attack him, he tries to talk his way out of it. So he doesn't actually do that much to save Mel, aside from providing a distraction. But when he is setting Mel free and sort of asks her very quietly and very earnestly, did I actually save someone for the first time? Mel very sensitively just says, yeah, I think you might have done, because she realises how important it is to Pex for him to be a protector. Despite the fact that he feels fear most of the time and is more of a posturing kind of figure, he's someone who does genuinely care for the place he lives and wants to be of service, but doesn't quite know how. And I think Mel recognises that in him, and as such, they start journeying together again. It is really quite a sweet scene, and even though I say Pex doesn't really rescue Mel without him... You know, Mel wouldn't have been rescued, so in a way, yeah, he did rescue her, but at the same time, it was hardly daring. It was a bit sort of Jerry Lewis or Mr. B sort of falling into the situation, and it just happens to work out pretty well. But from the very sort of broad kind of cannibalism of the Rezzies to a very quiet moment between Mel and Pex, it provides texture to this episode, and it does go to show that everything this story needed to be 10 out of 10 was on the page. It didn't quite happen in the execution, but there are moments of brilliance in here. And that's something really nice about Paradise Towers Part 3. Don't forget to subscribe, give me a thumbs up, and click the bell so you never miss one of these videos. Until next time, take care of yourselves, wash your hands, and I will see you in the next video. Thank you very much for watching.